tell they're putting it out over there. It's right up against those homes. See the crew suiting up. I think that guy over there, that's a fire. Someone, let me see. Yeah, right there. They're gonna tell us to get out of here. This guy right here is hosing down his yard. I think we'll be okay. Come the police. Our street just became a police staging area. Come this way, they're probably gonna tell me to get off the roof. doesn't that get you excited? They start marching up the hill.
Nice.
San Bernardino County right there. They're gonna hook up to a hydrant right there and protect these homes. Cause on my side of Haven, this is as high as it gets, that street right up there. And then it's our street. So they got one right there. And now they've got one right in here. Probably gonna bring in another one. A third one. Here comes a battalion chief or someone like that. These are all LA County right here. That is so tight. What they're worried about, like my neighborhood's kind of safe because there's no trees and there's just this brush right here that goes straight up at an angle to the mountain. What they're worried about, that brush, once it hits these foothills, it's gonna go straight to the top of Hermosa, which is covered in trees, eucalyptus trees. And that whole neighborhood, they're worried about those homes right there. So, they're actually going up to this street right here, I don't know why, but. It's only been 3 hours since it was on the other side of that ridge. Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. What? This is exciting. Thank you. police just told my neighbors that it's a mandatory evacuation. I'm gonna wait till they handcuff me before I leave. Just kidding. They just keep coming and coming. They're all going up into Havenview Estates protecting those homes. Every other house they're gonna park an engine. Bye! The neighbors just left. Who knows where they're going? Across the street. Firefighters up here. The big wash drainage system. And there's engines everywhere. And you can see up here, someone's soaking down something. I don't know if it'll help. That fire's so hot. They've got their sprinklers going. See firefighters in the back of their home. Probably laying down hose and stuff like that. Getting ready for their backyard. It's gonna be cooking. I'm surprised he didn't come talk to me. Hmm. Alright, sheriff department just came by. They said we have to go right now. Yeah, we have to go now. So, here's what the fire looks like last. It's getting close, so. Dang. Alright, it's 9 o'clock. I'm out of here. House is all locked up. Everything's off, TV's off. So, out of here. Here's one last look at it. How close is it? How close is the fire, sir?
I'm sorry?
How close is the fire, sir?
Right up at the top of Haven right there. This is going to be the final place they're going to hold it out, so this is your last chance to get out of here right now.
Okay. Okay? Thanks.
Be careful.
I will.
No, we didn't get there.
Los Angeles County Fire Department. Hey, Brother Olson. You know there's a fire up there?
Oh, yeah, no. See, all the way up. If you go by our wall here, you can see better this side.
Alright, here's down by the 210 freeway. See the 210 freeway sign right there. And that fire right there, that smoke, is right above Havenview Estates. So that's where it's at. It's burning all the way up the mountain. In our house, and this location is right up in there somewhere. See, everything's smoky and on fire. There's even some fire down over there. it's all above Havenview Estates.
Thank you.
Looks like they're stopping at a haven right there. This is what it looks like downtown Rancho Cucamonga. There's smoke everywhere. Can't even see anything. It's like nighttime. You can see all the ash on the ground. Good job, Tom.
Yeah, okay, thanks, man. What's up? So you're out here showing the labor board what we have to work in?
Yeah.
Okay, and
can't even breathe and
just,
talk.
Hey, man, this can't be held against me, this videotape, but I think this is wrong. Bad enough I can't breathe, but, you know, it says on the news that you shouldn't be doing this to people, but, you know, you can do what you want. It's about that mighty dollar, then. Hopefully I make some, too. That's it.
Quote, that your outtake?
Yep. Little play set. Back for notebook.
Is he going to be down soon, or what?
Look at my car! Ashes all over it. It's all over everything. Kinda see mountains up towards that way. Who knows where the fire's at now? Ha. Guess you snuck back up to the house. This is where the fire's at right now. It's a good sized flame. You can see they stopped it at Haven. The windy road that goes up to the foothills. Everything east of it's been burned. Everything on the west of it hasn't been. The fire was all up against that water tower. This is where it got charred. But there's ash everywhere. That flame's huge. And we're pretty well protected. Just go up here on the roof. We got two fire engines, one right behind this tree, one right here. So there's firefighters everywhere. I can't even talk, breathe, it's just getting in my mouth. So it didn't burn this ridge right here, this mountain, but it did on the other side where you can see the smoke. And right now the majority of it's right up there on the other side of the mountain. Kind of see where it's all charred.
Looking over the mountain.
Yeah.
And a few minutes ago, we're getting what you would call easy 200-foot flame lengths.
That's what that is right there?
And that would say, or you see that flare there?
Uh-huh.
What they're trying to do is they're trying to have the fires coming down towards us. They want to set fires below it. And you watch, you'll see what's going to happen, is that it's going to draw that fire up to the burning fire. It's like a chimney effect.
Uh-huh.
And that's going to keep save these houses, because it's going to keep the majority of that fire away from us, hopefully.
It'll only take half an hour to get down here.
If
the wind...
Now, if the winds do what they did just 15 minutes ago and they start blowing down canyon, if all that starts blowing at us, that's really bad for us. We don't want that. That's what they're going to try to prevent. See, there's a flare there. I don't know if you caught that on your film.
These houses right here are fine,
you're safe.
But up there, I don't know.
Yeah, and I don't know if it's on the news, but in Waterman Canyon, they're losing homes right now.
Waterman? On the other side or in Lake Arrowhead?
Lake Arrowhead, going toward the
Okay.
They've got homes that they're losing homes. It's a new fire and it's burning them.
Well, I'll be up on the roof until you guys kick me out again.
Okay, you're going to be all right.
Thanks.
Thank you for coming to the restaurant.
Francis's house is gonna get torched. That flare just backfired on them. They just torched Makeout Point. They're getting ready to go. Good luck! You can see how far it went. It's all the way over there now. Man, this whole mountain is on fire. firefighters are getting ready to... Dang. This is the closest the fire has been to our house since Tuesday. Here you can see, I don't know what to do, they're gonna hike up there. There's one guy already up here, just watching it. I don't know if you guys can tell, but from my eyes, those flames are several hundred feet, like 300 plus feet. That flame right there, the closest to those homes. See these firefighters right back here. They're just moving cardboard boxes and things like that out of the way. Man, even when the smoke kinda, not too much, but it just started going away, now it's all coming back right here. And everyone just kind of relaxed because they thought they got the fire down, but now you can see they're all coming back up. You can hear the sirens. This is kind of cool. A little funnel cloud of smoke. It's moving pretty quick. The whole mountain's on fire. You are not gonna believe these pictures. Hey, my battery's about to die, so... Jenny? I'll call you back. I gotta be inside, too, because I don't want the cops to see me. I want to get, like, good footage. I'll be safe. There's firefighters all around me. They're all around me. It's cool. Okay? Alright, babe. Bye. Love ya. See, the pool is just covered in ash. and everything around it. It's all ash from the fire. Got a fire truck right there. We're pretty safe. But those homes right up there, I don't know. We'll see. That fire's pretty close. tell the winds are blowing east right now. The way the smoke's coming off that mountain. So at least it's blowing away from those homes, which are right up there. Right now it feels like the wind's blowing at me, but maybe up there it's blowing east. There's the top of Haven. It's 4:20. Anyone want to go smoking? That's a house right there. That's close. That's a little too close for those firefighters. They better put that out. Tell the winds aren't, there's no winds right now because smoke's blowing straight up. But if the winds change and start blowing that way towards the west, then they're gonna have some big problems. Big problems. All right, this is what the fire looks like. 5:30. It's getting a little bit lower, but it's dying down pretty much. There is ash. All over the place. It's starting to get windy. This is what our swimming pool looks like, with a bunch of ash in it. That sucks. Like something's cooking over there. It's in the backyard of that home right there. Alright, Sunday morning. It's actually 5:33, not 6:33, because the clocks just got changed back. I'm coming home from Steve's house. I'm right before Mountain Avenue, south of Mount Baldy. And the fire's burned all the way over here on the 210 freeway. And it's right in this field. So it's getting close. They're probably going to shut this freeway down. So I got to get going, but there it is. Anyways, I got to get up to my house, see if it burned down. All right, I'm just getting out the freeway in the 210 on Archibald. And look how windy it is right now. Those are the Santa Ana winds, and that's not good. All right, it's 5:43 in the morning. You can see it's getting really windy here. Ah, my eyes. Our house is still here. The fire trucks are gone. You can see the mountain. It's kind of on fire, just a little bit. Ah. Sorry, I gotta get inside. Ash is blowing in my eyes real bad. Alright, this is looking out the window. See, our pool is completely dirty now. But I guess the fire didn't come this way. I don't know how far it burned down the hill. Last night I left, so I couldn't film it. But I'm guessing all this was burned. So we'll check in a few hours and see. I'm about to get out of here in a few seconds. It's in this field back here. Oh crap. I gotta get ready. I'm gonna leave this right here.
Zip up. Oh, man. 911's not even answering. I need a fire engine right behind my house, now. Top of Haven. Hidden Farm Road. Houses are... Hidden Farm. The second street from the top. There used to be three out here yesterday, now they're gone. There's $1 million houses going up. Please send them. Thank you. No, it's... They hung up on me. How gay. Oh well. Let's go through the house and check this out! Oh, shoot. Best up in my room. That whole field just went up. Oh dang. It's biggest back there. It's gonna whip around this house. I wonder if any of our neighbor's trees over there got burned. Police just knocked on my door telling me to get out of here, but. So much smoke out there. It's my mouth. All right, I'm going. We should be fine. Turn off all these lights. Turn off the computer. Died down. There's no threat anymore. man, my eyes, my mouth are covered in smoke and ash. Doesn't look like it started to burn around, but there's not much to burn on our field. Let's go see what's happening outside. Dang, only takes 5 seconds for that wind to kick that fire over here. I don't see any fire engines up that street. I don't see them out there. That's our smoke alarm. Those police officers aren't gonna do nothing. Mike left his door or his window open or something. Ash everywhere in my car. Dang it. I wonder if the sprinklers kick on when there's smoke alarm goes off. Mom, when do you think the fire's gonna get our house? I'm out of here. This firefighter's running, I'm running.
one firefighter up here. That sucks. That fire's out anyways. It's coming around the back of this house though. It's just a field. Hermosa Beach? Know how to put like a sand fire on the beach? What's this crap? Not anymore!
Okay,
you
gotta go.
I can't! It was just bottom of my stairs and up in my room. I saw the fire, not behind your house, but the house over. I called the fire before I said, get up. Kicking us out of here. Our house is fine. It's fine. Going now. I think that was the first guy that was here. Oh, Mom. Just kidding. Oh, man. Our house might go up. No. Breaks one of those windows, it'll take long. See all the neighbors right here evacuating from our street. Coming up here, everything north of these houses has been charred, and this is on Mayberry, turning right on Hidden Farm. You want to see shit's coming up here. I'm sure they soaked down our house, but we're gonna go up here. Still kind of smoking. See, it's on fire back up in there. all the foothills have been charred. I think this fire started up there on that hill or somewhere around up there. And you can see that where the Francises live up in these house area. There's a couple houses up there. But don't know if any of them are down, burned, or what. All these foothills up here have been burned all the way to the 15th freeway. It's so big. It's a huge fire. But you can see out the balcony. You can see where it's stopped. Alright, this is the very top of Haven, right above Haven View Estates. We're gonna go inside Haven View Estates right now. Check out. Dude, it's still smoking even right there. I guess it's just the roots burning. Something. Let's go check out what we can see. It's like it melted that fence. See, little field still on fire around here. These guys. Everything up against these homes. Doesn't look like any homes went up, but pretty close. This is where the Sarnowskis live, I believe, right here. like it's burning quite heavy over here in this field. Down by... Everything's been burned. Everything. All up along this mountain up here. People just leave fire hoses lying around out here. What's this? Crap. Just leave the hose out here. Why don't you? 2-inch hose. So you can kind of see, this is our house right there, back in the distance. This is where the fire came from.
I just got my kids and we went down to Hermosa and hung out in my classroom. And on Friday.
Say something for her. Give her some commentary.
Laura. We'll walk into your house. Show you what it looks like so you don't worry anymore. In a way, it's a good thing it got rid of all these weeds. You can see that the plastic melted down. I hope the horses are okay. Let's go take a look. There's some horses down over here. Miss Andress's house right here burned in the backyard. Her husband's a fireman. My house is burned at the top of Sapphire where I used to live. Not too bad up here. It's not too smoky anymore. It smells, but the ash isn't too bad anymore.
I want to show them this, Jenny. Look how bad this got. It burned the plastic and the rocks. You can see all this is burnt. It's all burnt right over here. But then you just go across the thing here, and it's all lush and green. It doesn't look like it touched any of it. We even got wildlife, apparently. So we're not sure if the firemen put this part out or if it was stopped because of this gravel road. But it's just really weird how that happened.
This is where the horses are. Let's figure them out. Did you live around here?
Yeah.
Is your house okay?
Yeah.
Did any of the houses burn down up here?
I don't think so. No, no,
I do. What kind of questions can you ask them? I can't get it because it's locked off the most.
We're on.
Okay, Laura, walking down your street so we could show you what it looks like. You can see that the mountains are burned down, but the woods are safe. Let's go. See, right? right here behind this house got burned. Come here, look how close it came. Came right across the street from you, Laura. See that? The Spencers live right here, right? That I called?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Is it on?
Yep.
Laura, this is right across the street from your house. Your house is okay. It's pretty bad. The weed's pretty good. I see some smoke up there still. Good.
Everything appears normal. No scorch marks on the driveway. All the shrubbery is still here. Now you have a nice clean view of the cul-de-sac. And a burnt tree. That looks pretty neat, actually, the way it's burnt. I don't know about that, but it's probably just because I'm weird.
Okay, let's turn it off.
All right, this is down the street from Chaffey College, near where the Cottoms live. And actually, you can see the back of Los Osos High School. And all of the where it's been burned back there. So this is the back of it, right behind Chaffey College and Deer Creek. So this whole field back, there's nothing back here for miles. Just these shrubberies and the mountain up there on the hill. And you can see if this wash weren't here, and if these homes weren't shingled with cement shingles and stucco, it burned it all down, but burned all the way up the mountain. Still kind of smoky all around. Kind of see smoke coming off of Cucamonga Peak. Anyways, and there's the fire in San Bernardino coming together with the fire in Lytle Creek and the Grand Prix fire. So that's where the start of it was, over there. And it's burned all the way over this whole mountain. It's way over there now. You can see how close the fire got to Banyan Street, right on the west side of Los Osos, coming up to Milliken. Burned right to the street. All these trees and everything gone. Here's Los Osos. Okay, this is east of Los Osos. You can see the whole field's burned. All the way up until into Banyan Street. It's all charred. And just went around these neighborhoods. Firefighters backed up right along these washes to stop the fire. So it looks like all these houses are here. And looks like it didn't get into that field. But this is the neighborhood of Day Creek. You might have heard of that on the news. So let's go up in here. This is at the top of Day Creek, and you can see there's brand new structures up here. This one's all metal though. But down below that, there's brand new homes made of wood. Wood's all showing, but you can see all around these communities, up into the hills. You can see the fire still burning over there by the Cajon Pass, 15 freeway. But all along the foothills and the main mountain have been burned. You can see the area about where our house is right up in there somewhere. Can't see it at all, but it's been a nice sight to see these trees go up, the firefighters. But all up in these canyons, the little ridges, all back behind there, it's all burned. Nothing left but dirt and rock. And so this is the neighborhood between Milliken and Etiwanda. Okay, this is over in Etiwanda. You can see right up against Summit Intermediate School or Elementary School, whatever that is. It's burned all up in these fields. This is getting close to the 15 freeway. This is when the road you get used to get onto the 15 freeway from Etiwanda. 15 freeway is closed down because of all this smoke up here. But you can see right up against, this is Summit Avenue or Banyan, some street like that. Burned on both sides of this street. This is about Wednesday, or sometime around that day when it burned. See, I wonder if this is the helicopter that was engulfed in flames that you saw on the news. No, that was a yellow one. This is probably another one. On this side right here, it looks like it wasn't burned at all, but maybe a little bit, but it got pretty hot. Alright, now we're at Wilson, so we're just going to keep going straight up here. You can kind of see the sun setting over there. Everything north up here, it's just nothing but field all the way to my house, all the way to Claremont, pretty much. Just all this open field was burned. Over 15,000 acres of field was burned up in this area. So, just watching the sun go down. Gone now. Here's a house that's out in the middle of nowhere. Didn't get touched, but the fire's all around it, so. This is the area where the fire started, somewhere around here. I don't know why they call it the Grand Prix Fire. I think it's the street that it started off of. But you can see there's some big homes up here. There's that one. And smaller home over here. But we're going to go up here and check it out. So Lido Creek is over those hills right there. And over this hill. So that's where the fire's at right now. You can see this neighborhood over here where I'm looking at is Hunter's Ridge. Pretty close to the 15 freeway. In fact, I can zoom in on the 15 freeway. It's right there, but this is up against the hills where it was burned. You can see all southern points of the fire up against Wilson Avenue in between these neighborhoods right here. So just show. That right down there is the 15 freeway. So pretty close. Burned right in between these neighborhoods. Okay, you can see where the fire is burning now, Sunday afternoon, up in the Cajon Pass area. Starting to burn towards Lake Arrowhead and that area, but in between these two ridges, you see, it's Cajon Pass, and this is actually the 15 freeway right along here. If you look back, that neighborhood up there is Hunter's Ridge. So somewhere in this area is where the Grand Prix fire started. And see back here, there's a chip not letting anyone on the freeway to go north on the 15 because of all the smoke up here and fire's getting close. So pretty much from the 15 freeway all the way to LA County line, which my house is right in the middle of all that. There's nothing left, vegetation-wise, on the mountain. The whole mountain's been burned, everything. And it's already gone over the freeway, and that's where it's at right now. Just another mountain. This is facing west. Let's see. There's a cop. Check this out. It's made it all the way to the very top of Cucamonga Peak. Let's see if I can solve her a little bit. That's where the fire's at right now above my house. There's nothing left below it to burn, so there's no danger, but stop right here and videotape this. This is so cool. I thought it was all rock up there, but I guess there's still some brush and stuff. Everything below that has been burned. It's probably burning on the backside too.